escaped damage from the fire. And some historians believe Nero has been the responsible person for that fire, although his involvement was not clear. So parang nagkaroon ng parang tyranny. And there was a big fire, and people were saying it was Nero, but it was not really proven. Even there is a big proof that it was him, but of course nobody would like to mention that clearly. And what is clear that Nero deflected the focus from himself by blaming the fire on the Christians. Remember at that time, nung nagkaroon ng sunog, when there was a big fire, instead of focusing the reason to Nero, what Nero did was he basically focused the issue to the Christians. Remember during that time, the Pentecost, they were, you know, remember, nagkakaroon sila ng drinking of wine and breaking of the bread. And diba, remember when they were doing the Last Supper, they were saying, this is the body of the Lord Jesus Christ and this is the wine that symbolizes the blood. So basically, Nero was saying those people were cannibals because they were eating bodies and drinking the blood. And this is how Nero tried to, binibrainwash yung mga tao. And that's the reason why he told the people that it was not me who burned this city, but those cannibals. Okay, this is based on history, okay? This is based on history. So, So he was blaming the fire on the Christians, and many whom he tortured and killed. The historian Tacitus described these autocracies covered with the skin of beasts, were torn by dogs and ferries, and they were nailed to the cross. Remember, Peter was nailed on the cross upside down? Remember that? That is how Peter, the one who wrote this letter, he was nailed on the cross upside down. They were doomed in flames and burnt to serve nightly illumination when daylight has expired. So the Christians are being burned and they are being served as a lamppost. Sila yung mga Christian at that time, they were burned para during the celebration of Nero, sila yung nagsisilbing ilaw. And that is how cruel Nero is. Nero used of Christians as human torch to light his evening garden parties is well documented. And ultimately, it is the brutality inflicted on the early Christians for which Nero is best being remembered. Pagka sinabi natin si Nero, people will know him. He is the cruel emperor. And this he is well famous for. And that is why, you know, before Peter was put to death, he penned this letter, itong 1 Peter. Kasi at that time, people are being persecuted, being in trial, being in trouble. Right? So Peter wrote this letter to encourage and to explain to them why they suffer. And it's what is the implication and what is the reward of these trials. He emphasized to the Christians that they can expect suffering as a natural part of life dedicated to Christ. So yun pala yun. So that's why it is that we Christians should expect suffering and trials in our life. And we need to expect that as a natural part of our daily life dedicated to Christ. If you are suffering and you're not dedicating your life to Christ, then this doesn't belong to you. You know, you are not part of this letter. But if you are suffering because of Christ, and then this letter belongs to us. So that is the background about Peter when he penned this letter. That was what is happening at that time. There are a lot of troubles. There are a lot of persecution. So in the same way, we can sympathize. Because even up to now, we are also encountering troubles in our own little way. Right? Sino ba sa atin ang walang trouble? Who among us is not facing troubles and trials? Lahat naman tayo dumadaan sa trials, diba? Lahat tayo na all of us is going through some testing. But the point is, what can we learn from this letter? How can we encourage ourselves during the time of trials and testing? And if I remember it right, this is what we have discussed during our Wednesday Bible study. And I just simply would like to share it with you as well. What are the things that we can consider to do or to think in order for us to triumph on trials and troubles? Ano ba tayo, ano ba sa Tagalog ng triumph on? Yung mapapagtagumpayan yung mga trials and troubles na dumadating sa atin. Kaya, should we do something about it? Can we try to analyze things and do some solutions? Let's see what Peter recommended for us. Number one, I only have prepared 3 points for you. And in order for us to troubles and trials, number one, in times of troubles, we have to do or we have to understand praises. This is what he said. Sabi niya sa verse 3. Sabi niya ganun, All praise to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, it is by which great mercy that we have been born again, because God raised Jesus Christ from the dead, now we live with great expectation. So, Peter, you know that there are a lot of crimes happening right now. Christians are being burned, and Christians is being persecuted by Nero, and then you are going to tell us all praises? Pinapatay na yung mga anak ko. You know, all my relatives are being murdered by Nero, and then you will say, praise to God? Did you know that we are already in the pit of troubles and trials and persecution? And then you will still say, praise to God? You know, sa atin ngayon, most of the time we are facing trials and troubles, temptations, testing. And what is the first thing that comes to our mind? Is it praises sa Panginoon? I hope we do. Minsan, tendency, people will try to run away if there are trials and troubles. Some people will resort on alcohol. Some people will resort on drugs. Some people will resort on, good times. Pero what Peter is saying here is praises. All praises to God. Kanina daw, whom should we give our praises to God? The Father of the Lord Jesus Christ. For what reason? What did God the Father do? You could see here one thing. Sabi ng ganon, God raises. I already highlighted it. Because God raised Jesus Christ from the dead. We have to praise God because God raises Jesus Christ from the dead. God the Father, of course, we're talking about God the Father here. He raises Jesus Christ from the dead. And we have to be in praise for that. And because God the Father raised Jesus Christ from the dead, the result is we have a priceless inheritance. You know, we have a priceless inheritance in heaven. Anong sabi doon? Because of His great mercy, we have been born again. Sabi niya ganon. Because God raises Jesus Christ from the dead, now we live with great expectation. Sabi niya ganon, there is now hope. And let's see, what did the Lord, what did God do? So, first one is, He raises Jesus Christ from the dead. And another thing is, on verse 5, we can see here, and through your faith, God is protecting you. So, by His power, until we receive this salvation, which is ready to be revealed in the last day. So, there are two things that God the Father is doing. Have done, and is still continuously doing. Number one, is He raised Jesus Christ from the dead. And number two, He is protecting us continuously until our salvation has come to materialize. Yung sa binasa na natin sa verse 5. So, what does this all mean? Yung binasa natin from verse 3 to verse 5. Basahin ko lang ulit, ha? Sabi nga naman, all praises to God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, it is by His great mercy that we have been born again. Because God raised Jesus Christ from the dead. It is not us who raised Jesus Christ from the dead, but it is God So now the result is we could have great expectation. And verse 4, and we have, this is the result. Because God raised Jesus Christ from the dead, we now have priceless inheritance. You know, an inheritance that cannot decay and that is undefiled. Meaning, hindi na mawawala. Hindi na magbabago. It will never change. So, kaya nga, importante maintindihan natin na if we have the salvation, it can never be ruined. Walang makasira ng salvation na yun. Kaya nga, there is permanence. You know, yung sa baba. Ibig sabihin is, ano na siya, yung in place. No one can touch it. Permanent. From the root word, permanent. Our salvation is permanent when we accepted the Lord Jesus Christ. Ano yung sabi kanina sa verse 3? There is proof. Ibig sabihin, there is a proof that Jesus Christ already conquered yung victory over the cross. Okay, so that's the reason why we have to praise. Even though we have all these sort of trials, we have to praise the Lord because Jesus Christ already won the battle. But when He has been raised by God from the dead, meron na tayo, we can claim that there is a proof. No one can reprove that. Actually, last night, I was watching that movie, God is Not Dead, Part 2. And it was a good movie. I would encourage you to watch it. People are trying to dissolve the idea that God is still existing. Pero no one can disapprove the idea that God is alive. He is alive and He is alive indeed.